Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. Today we are going to talk about bed plate crack and how we are going to rectify or how we are going to deal with if a bed plate crack occur in a ship. So let's begin the video. Welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. Today we are going to talk about bed plate crack. So why do a bed plate crack occur? Bed plate crack occur because of this following reason. First is the loose tie bolt. If the tie bolt is loose, in that case bed plate crack occur. Why? Because bed plate is been held in compression along with the A-frame and entablature by the tie bolt, and if it get loose, in that case uneven load distribution will occur, which can causes the development of bed plate crack. Now second point, misalignment of bed plate due to uneven wear of chock. Chock help to maintain the alignment of the bed plate along with the other part of the component of the engine, like for the propeller shaft. If the alignment is not maintained properly, then uneven wear will occur, and which may lead to the development of crack, or the misalignment can also cause uneven load distribution and thrust distribution, which may also cause the development of crack because of also uneven thrust distributed. Now uneven firing, suppose uneven firing occurs because of the, suppose one unit not working or two or three unit not working, in that case uneven firing of the cylinder occur, or if the injector in two or three cylinder is choked or not properly firing, in that case the load distribution occurring on the bed plate is not proper, and hence it may lead to the development of crack. Now the question come to our mind that why, where the this crack occurs. So this crack occurs in the change in section around the bed plate bearing pocket. As you can see, this is a transverse girder. Here the bottom, here the main bearing general will be installed and the crankshaft will pass through. Now this change in section, if this change in section is not smooth, then this may act as a stress raiser, and if an hairline crack develop, in that case this stress raiser will aggravate the crack development. Now one more thing, the transverse girder is subjected to severe load during firing cycle of the engine. As we know that the weight of the firing is being taken up by the bed plate and transmitted to the hull through as a thrust through which the ship move forward. Now if this load firing severe, this load is uneven, then the load distribution will be uneven, and when the load is transmitted, it causes the circumferential and radial direction stress, and if this stress is uneven, then the crack development may occur like this. The circumferential crack development may occur or radial direction crack may occur. Okay, now we will come that what action we are going to take if a bed plate crack occur. Okay, now if a bed plate crack occur, first thing we are going to do is the inform the class and the DPA assure. Okay, by informing them we can get an idea and we can get to know what are the action taken along with the good communication. Okay, second thing, we will check the cause of the crack. Means sometime it occurs that, as I have told you, uneven firing and misalignment may be the reason. So first our main aim is to remove the cause. If uneven firing is occurring, then why the uneven firing is occurring? If the injector is choked, or if the unit not firing properly, that we will see and we will prevent that. Okay, or if the engine not aligned, we will take the crankshaft wave deflection, we will align the engine. Okay, after doing that we will check, depending upon the extensivity of the crack, engine max load can be reduced and crack to be monitored regularly. Now suppose a small crack occur like here. Okay, in that case we can't replace the whole transfer girder because it is a costly affair. Okay, so what we'll do, we will reduce the load of the engine. Means a small amount of load will be, max load will be reduced, and we will continue the monitoring over a period of time to see that if the crack is developing further or not. If it is not, well and good, we will continue to run the engine in that reduced max load. Now, if the crack is propagating, if the crack is propagating over a period of time, in that case we need to take the repair in hand. So what we'll do, one option is the in situ repair. So what is in situ repair? In situ repair, the crack repairing work is carried out in situ, involving weld repair of crack or replacement of bearing girder. Means in place we are replacing the bearing girder. Means this part we are replacing in place, okay, without replacing the whole component of the bed plate. Means the particular girder which has been infected is been cut out and the new one is placed and welded, and after that the engine is stress relieved. Okay, that we can do. But if the crack is occurred too large, means suppose if the crack has taken place in the transfer girder in circumferential or radial direction or in the longitudinal girder, in that case what will happen? In that case, we if two or three transfer girder or longitudinal girder is infected, in that case we have to change the whole bed plate. Okay, if the crack is too large, then whole bed plate to be renewed in the CPR, and for that we have to reach the dry dock and we will carry out the repair work. I hope you understand what are the action you are going to take if a bed plate crack occurs. Please do like and subscribe my video, and please share if you like it. Email credit goes to marinediesel.co.uk. Thank you, friend.